I'm exactly why you're here. I'd like to take Tash away. It's been some time, that's just us.
Tara's just gone through the process of making you a guardian. Why would she do that if she wanted to get her daughter back?
Well, maybe she changed her mind, you know. I've been granted additional guardianship of one Natasha Hedemeyer. She's a grown woman, she'll understand.
What's that more?
I'm sorry.
I need to go back to Oz. Tasha's coming with me. It's what we both want.
We wanted to tell you as soon as we got back from the snow, but with Victor being arrested, we couldn't find the right time.
Is that what you want to do, girl? You want to go and live in Oz?
She didn't know how to tell you.
Can you see the girl speak?
I want to be with my mum. I'm sorry.
I could give you two some time.
I can't. I've got to get into work and go to Victor's bail hearing.
Well, when you get back then. I make myself scarce, so I'll give you guys some space. Okay, Tash.
Hey, Winch on the run. Must be busy.
I got a lot to get through before Victor's bail hearing.
No, I thought as much. Anything I can do to help?
Not unless you've earned yourself a medical degree overnight.
No, I was thinking more about making phone calls or juggling appointments.
Got part for that?
But you are. Well, I look forward to hearing Victor's out on bail.
I look forward to telling you.
Lena Morrissey. How'd it go last night?
She has her heart set on a mastectomy reconstruction. Unfortunately, given her history, we're going to have to do the op separately. She's seeking a second opinion and getting back to me.
Have you got a file there?
Yeah.
I might give her a call, see how she's going. I was a fifth point of contact, it only seems professional.
And good PR, the caring face of the unit?
Yeah, that too.
If she needs a mastectomy urgently, tell her I can do it in the next couple of days.
Or sooner. The Vraz is a gap fixed up tomorrow.
Really? I thought he was...
Yeah, cancellation. You don't mind, do you?
No, whatever she wants to do.
Excellent.
Hey, guys.
How are you from here?
I come bearing cake. Put you my wife some.
Sorry, we're not allowed to accept food from strangers.
Yes, well, this stranger has chocolate eclairs, some caramel concoction, and custard tarts.
She's off to Tarshville.
I haven't seen her for days, and besides, she's got something here to tell me.
Well, I already told you about cookie cart.
What is something else, personal?
And what, I can't wait till tomorrow?
Dad!
With Christ in the fear in her eyes, she's scared to death that her girlfriend's found somebody new.
Oh, shut up. At least I've got a best friend.
Oh, I'm so jealous.
Leave it, Jake.
Send me an eclair and some of that caramel stuff.
Sure. He'll be lucky. Dinner's at 7. If you need a lift, give me a call.
I will. See ya, thanks.
See ya.
Yeah, I'd stay and do quality time, Craig, but hell, what will we talk about?
He's gone home to see his kids.
How do you know I was looking for Craig?
Oh, who says I'm talking about Craig?
Don't try and be clever, Vinny. It doesn't suit you.
So are you looking for the bus?
It's a work thing, all right?
Geez, okay.
I mean it. I'm sick of the talk. It's affecting my career.
Yeah.
Craig actually believes it. He thinks I tried to get him in the sack when all I ever wanted was professional guidance.
He doesn't seem the type to listen to gossip.
She's just being paranoid.
Excuse me. He used to appreciate my ambition. He understood it. Now he's going out of his way to avoid me. Notice that I'm here now, he isn't.
Yeah, but...
I know exactly what's going on, and I'm not going to put up with it.
I hope this discussion relates to a patient.
Ah, yes. Asian, female, medical professional. Symptoms? Totally psychosomatic.
Just get on with some work. Maya, I need you.
Sure.
Oh, to be the teacher's pet.
What's it for? You told me you were talking about me.
So?
I think it's fresh gossip. As if her opinion of me isn't low enough already.
Yeah, well, that's what you get for cuddling the daughter's husband. Naughty, naughty doctor.
Anne and Victor were never right for each other. Tama and Shannon, different story. Oh, now Victor's story.
Yeah.
Victor tells his story. Everyone will hate me. Except perhaps Judy, I'll probably be your favourite.
Because?
They blew his alibi. Got him arrested.
Eh?
I was with him the night of the murder. But I wasn't sure he was with me the whole time, and I wasn't going to lie to the police about it. I mean, would you? No, you wouldn't have. Not if you'd been there. I only did what anyone else would have done.
Hello to Uncle.
Oh, that was the best phone call, Dad. I've never been so pleased to hear your voice.
Yeah, and I've never been so pleased to hold a cell phone. Nothing like being locked up to make you appreciate the little things.
So it's all sorted then, you just carry on with your life?
Well, as long as I stay put and don't try to do a runner.
Which you never would, because there's nothing to run from. Even the judge could see that. I reckon she would have biffed the case out there and then if she could have.
And the good news you haven't heard, he's been granted name suppression.
Nothing in the papers. Oh, that's good.
Yeah, only thanks to Chris putting in a good word.
It's the top result all around.
I think it deserves a little drink, yeah?
Aye, kia ora.
Hey, tuko.
I've made a bit of a welcome home cry as well.
Oh, kia ora, Tama. Haven't eaten all day.
Yeah, I guess the food was pretty...
Don't get me started.
I should be getting back to make sure the factory hasn't burnt down.
Rubbish. Stay for a drink and a bite to eat.
Chris, there's plenty here.
Yeah, and Barb will call you if you need you.
Oh, go on then, twist my arm.
Didn't take much.
Yeah, I've always been a pusher.
All right, then I'll get the glasses.
Hey, it's nice. I should have been out with her mum.
Oh, it's wonderful to be here.
Oh, I haven't got this. Hi, Donna speaking.
Hi, it's me. I just wanted to let you know I've got Tash down at the dogs. Yes, you wanted to see your friend Scarlett.
Right.
Listen, you and I, we need to sit down and talk.
Victor got bail, by the way.
Oh, excellent. Great.
I haven't got any money.
I'll connect. Hang on a sec.
Thanks. Hey, don't be long. You can say hi to Scarlett.
It'll be 5 minutes, promise.
John, are you still there?
Yeah.
Look, I'm going to be at the bar waiting for Tash. Why don't you come down and meet me there?
Yeah, now's not a really good time. We've just got back.
Well, maybe later. In an hour or two?
See how you place, yeah?
Okay.
Way better.
Terry. Well, it turns out that Terry does want to take Tash back to Oz. And Tash wants to go.
So, how was skiing?
It was good,
yeah. And what's been like to your mum? That's huge news. Is she married or something?
No, but she's different. Like, she's really changed.
What, in a good way?
Yeah, like all that stuff I told you about her not caring. She feels so bad about it.
In a bed. So when does she leave?
So, a couple of days. And I'm going with her.
For a holiday?
No. I'm going to live in Australia. For good.
Gosh, why?
Because she's really changed.
But what about Donna?
Yeah, I'm going to miss her. Heaps. And you.
I can't believe it.
It's really different when your mum actually turns up. You'd feel the same.
You would.
Please don't be mad at me.
When are you leaving?
You know the way, probably. But we'll still be friends, Scarlett. And you have to come over for the summer holidays. Mum said that'd be cool.